Ladies and gentlemen, and as Paul told, my hobby at the same time profession is physics, and this is for me very lucky coincidence. And I think, as Democritus once said, I can also repeat now that I would rather prefer to discover one causal law than to be a king of Persia. And I am pretty sure there is a lot of phenomena awaiting our discovery. Oh, let me know. Yeah, that's work. Which are occurring perhaps even now here, but we do not recognize them. And I have my personal proof for that, at least, which is convincing me that that was an astonishment. I had experienced one when working at this nice and even cozy accelerator, when a friend of mine came to my office and and something like that happened, and then he told me, please pick it up because this is an external call. So I excused him for a moment, and then it was indeed an external call, and then I asked him, how do you know that? And then this was an explanation. You know, this was the external call, and this is internal call. Many of you are also working in the institutions. You perhaps recognize that. I was working there for many years in that office and didn't realize that. And I learned a good lesson of humility, a painful lesson for the researcher whose ambitions is of discovering, say, less trivial things than that. So, but this gives me also a promise that there is a chance to discover something which I didn't notice till now. And today I would like you to tell a story, more successful for me at least, about antimatter-based molecular imaging of the whole human body. So what I mean by that? So I would like to tell you about the idea or an invention about a cylinder, a device which is perhaps someday surrounding the person. And with that device, I hope we will be able in the future to make the tomographic images, the non-invasive pictures of the human body, of the whole human body. So perhaps in less scientific topic of my presentation today could be how I have reinvented the cylinder. But now, after you laughed truly when Charles Crawford was showing a formula, I think I am obliged now to give a lesson before we go further of the solid-state physics, atomic physics, nuclear physics, and then on the end, the particle physics. That's all we need to understand the rest of the talk. But then, since some of you, I see here the colleagues from my institute, younger, had perhaps already attended such lectures, I will make it in the way I am sure you, none of you have shown, because I would like to start from, I should point it here, from the bush, which I make a photo, the bush of my garden. So as a researcher, you may just put a head inside that, and then you recognize there is a lot of fruits there. Yeah? But with the scope, perhaps you could go further. And now let us skip the molecular physics. These fruits are surely from molecules, and the molecules are from atoms. So now we are ready at the atomic physics, and this is now very important to recognize that, and this is really important for the next of the talk, that this is not to scale. And I could not plot it to scale, because that's nucleus is much smaller in comparison to the size of the atom, and that is why some of the particles can just traverse through the human body or through the matter if they are energetic enough. And then in the next week, let us go to the nuclear physics. This is the nucleus, and then quickly to the particle physics. Nucleus is out of quarks. And then now, going back to this word antimatter, now we come really to the point. There are also quarks and anti-quarks. So they are objects which I am really studying in my daily life, which are called mesons, not important for that talk, but I am doing that, so I had to mention that. And that mesons are built out of matter and antimatter. And that's why they can live only very shortly. If those quark and anti-quark touch each other, it disappears in the form of the energy. And now, for the imaging, we need something similar, but we cannot have a meson in the laboratory because it lives for a while, not worth to mention. But there is another source of antimatter we have in the laboratories, in most of the nuclear physics laboratories, which is the isotopes, the atoms or the substances like fluor, like oxygen, but which can radioactively decay, and this we all know. But there is one radioactive decay which is very special, which is out of those three, alpha, beta, and gamma. Beta is the most mysterious one or the most mystic, and this is like that. Then one of the nucleus, one of the nucleon inside the nucleus decays, as it was shown here. Oh, let me come back. To anti-electron, this E plus here is not an electron, but an anti-electron. Electron has minus. And this is anti-electron. This is something which, if it touched the electron, then the annihilation occurs and you have the energy. So now, which is already used in the world, you can cheat a little and make, for example, a radioactive sugar instead of usual sugar. The radioactive sugar is just a sugar made of, for example, with this fluor, but instead of usual fluor, you take the radioactive fluor which then emits the positrons, those anti-electrons. And you can administer that to the patient, like you see on that picture. And then all the processes with the sugar which occur in the body are exactly the same as with the usual sugar, but from time to time you have a signal from the interior of the body because this decay happens there. And now if you look, if this decay happens somewhere, you have then this anti-electron. If it touches the electron, we are in the first order from electrons and those nuclei, nothing else. So if it touched this electron, then they annihilate because it was matter and antimatter, and those two photons, two gamma quanta, are flying in the line apart from each other. And they are energetic. They are energetic enough to go through the atoms. So they can go outside of the body. And now we are close to the explanation of that word. So we had a positron, we had emission, and now we have detectors, so we have positron emission tomography. With those detectors, now it's enough to put around the human body detectors which are capable of detecting those gamma quanta, and you can make a picture of the interior of the body, or in the first place, you can make a picture where those sugar were distributed around the organism. And now, you may wonder how one can do that. I have an easy example, the simplest one. Let's assume the full sugar administered was just absorbed in one place in the brain. Let's say the person, unlucky, had a cancer, and this was absorbed really point-like in one place. Then it's very easy to imagine how you can make a picture of that brain or that point, because what we measure, blue rectangles are detectors, something which can register, a bulb. If you put the current into the bulb, then you see the light. If you put the light to the detectors, you see the current. Just say it's anti-bulb. So what we have, we gave a sugar, then this sugar sometimes is decaying somewhere. In that case, it's decaying always here, and we measured here signal and here signal. There is a lot of cables there, but we know it was here and here. So we, what we may do is to plot a line. But we don't know when this sugar was along this line. But it is, of course, decaying in different directions. So in, it's enough to have two such lines, and you know the point. So now it's very easy to imagine that you can make such a picture of the full body. Okay, it's not that easy as I plotted now, but you... but it's imaginable. And this is how the person see that. So you put your to some plastic box, and then on the screen you have the picture of your brain. But now, what is the problem to be solved, or what is the challenge here? The challenge is that such devices are very expensive, 20 millions of Polish złoty, what one, so there is only a few of such of them in Poland. They are short, it means you cannot make an image of the whole person. As you saw on this picture, there are short rings around the patient. And now, there is one more problem or a challenge, how to improve the such sharpness of that image. And now, please look, please look at that picture here. This is a picture I would like to explain you the problem with the smearing of the image. So let's say this anti-electron, touch electron here, we had two photons, two gamma quanta, and they react here and here. But we don't know this. We know only that it was somewhere in that detector, because we have here a cable and the signal from that detector. Sorry. So now, what we can plot is the line from the middle of the detector to the middle of the detector. So we make a mistake, because we know, in that case, we know the true line is here, but we reconstruct that line. And this caused the smearing of the image. So now there is one trivial way to overcome this. The trivial way is to make these detectors smaller and smaller, but then you increase and increase the costs, because you increase the number of the bulbs. And this is now the idea I had. Just instead of making that, let's change completely the paradigm. Let's use the huge block instead of small pieces, and let's try to find something out when this gamma heated the detector inside. And this is just the idea, which is the direct transfer of the detectors we have in that experiment. This is one of the experiments I spent perhaps 15 years of researching with that. And with that detectors, we are measuring time of, we are studying those mesons. And we are measuring, this is part of the accelerator, we are measuring the time particles traverse from here to here. This is nanoseconds, very short time. But if you look at that, this was strips of such a plastic material which allowed to measure the particles. In closer view, it may be plotted like that. You have a strip of the material. If something hits it, a particle, a gamma quanta, then there is a light inside. And if it is in the middle, then the time of the light signal to that side, to this bulb, and to that bulb is the same. If it is closer to that, PM is not the abbreviation of my name, it is photomultiplier. If it is closer to that, then this time is shorter, this time is longer. So from the difference of times, you can define when this gamma quanta really hit it. Very simple. This is used in all physics experiments, particle and nuclear physics experiments. And now, the only thing to make now was how out of that to make the tomograph. And then, this is again something like inventing the circle. One can think of taking this wall of those strips and make a cylinder out of that. And now you have those strips. You can put a bulb here, bulb there, so you know when this gamma from the human body hit it in which way. You can put a patient here inside. This can be large. The number of those photomultipliers or those bulbs do not increase when you enlarge that. You make it as large as you like. Even more, you can make more of such cylinders, and then you can increase the probability of detecting this gamma quanta. So now the dream which we are trying to realize with my colleagues is to build such a tomograph which would allow for such molecular imaging of the whole human body. Now it's clear. But now what is with that? Now, you may believe or not, I conceived that cylinder out of that detector which you show. But then I realized that I am working in the collaboration in the laboratory who has such a cylinder. This is that one in Italy, 4 meter large with scintillators with those material, and we are making experiments there. Then I, when preparing this talk, oh, then again, I realized that I am working at the experiment which has such a huge barrel of scintillator, and I am working in another experiment which, when you look inside, there is again a barrel of the scintillator. So you may look here how large those barrels are. The person can even walk inside if this would work. So there is a chance to really do such a tomograph, especially that such a technology is used nowadays in the particle and nuclear physics. And I hope, as Rafał told us, that somebody takes seriously his message and will just, somebody clever will make these tomographs in some groups which are rich enough to build all those bulbs and so on. But independently, I with my colleagues are trying to do that here in Krakow. And then this is just to point the end of my talk. Thank you very much.